Hi, this is Mike Wallach with TriMech. I want to show you an approach to optimizing downloaded models. So I downloaded this screw from a popular website, and this is a purchase component that's going to be used in my assemblies. Well, I want to check performance evaluation first, and I can see here that it has 39,546 graphics triangles, 370 faces, and the total rebuild time is 0.78 seconds. Now, that's not a big deal once, but all of this is going to add up in the assembly as the screw is used multiple times. So I'm going to take a snip so that we can compare the before and after. So here's our before. I'm just going to take this section right here. And we're going to pull that over to another screen and look at it after doing some optimization. So I'm going to go to Options, Document Properties, Image Quality, and notice the slider is turned up very high. This is so that the part looks nice for people who download it. But this comes at the expense of higher numbers of graphics triangles, larger file size, slower performance. So I'm going to move this down to the 10% mark. So we'll get cruder looking graphics, but better performance. And really, from a distance, it doesn't make much difference anyway. So now let's look at performance evaluation. And graphics triangles are now down from nearly 40,000 to less than 16,000. Face count is unaffected. Now, let's suppress some features. We don't need accurately modeled threads. We don't really need to display the threads at all. I can see that Cut Sweep 1 is a child feature of Helix Spiral. So if I suppress this feature, then its child will go with it. I also don't need this knurling. So here, that's this cut extrude, and dynamic reference visualization is showing me that these two chamfers in this circular pattern are all children of that feature, so I'll suppress that one, and those are all suppressed. I also don't need this curved face here. Curved faces result in a lot more graphics triangles than flat ones, so let's suppress that feature. Now, we have these two billets, which are a small radius, and this chamfer over here, which is going to give us more triangles and a little more geometric complexity. Those all come from the initial revolve. So rather than changing the sketch, I'm going to use the delete face command. The delete and patch option, and get rid of those faces. And it'll just extend the other faces in order to fill in the gaps. Now I've got a drastically simplified screw, and let's check performance evaluation. So we're now down from the original 39,546 graphics triangles to 232. Face count is down from 370 to 13, and total rebuild time has dropped from 0.78 to 0.06. So now this screw will have a pretty negligible effect on my assemblies. I hope you found that useful. Have a good day.